everyone. Guy's guitar. There you go. I can write a note. We're going to start the show in just a minute.
I'll just sing a little song while we're waiting.
That was beautiful, Sealy.
It's tiny.
There, look. I'll just do that. Does that look great?
Well,
cover the whole screen.
Yeah.
In that. Which now does not want to do it. So I guess we're not going to do that. I'll be right back.
Mm-hmm. Hello, Internet. We're getting ready to broadcast our show. It's Wednesday. So, buckle up. The actual show is starting at 9 o'clock, and this is the inactual show. I'd like to play a little inactual music for you for the inactual show.
I'm taking you.
So is anybody out there? Internet?
There's a few people watching.
Hello, Internet!
Hello, Internet!
Knock, 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 Internet!
Thanks for being here.
Let us in.
We've decided we're going to start going live a little bit earlier instead of just going live right at 9 o'clock on Channel 16 in Austin. We're starting at around 8:45 so that we can, not have no sound when it's time to go.
Yes, this way we can make sure that everything is going according to Jeska's plan.
And my plans are grand.
For domination.
Domination.
Of Channel 16.
Going to the chat app.
The chat app.
The chat app.
Chat app, chat app, chat app, chat app.
Sounds like you're saying some not as nice things.
Here's a song that I thought about playing and maybe we'll play sometime soon.
We have 4 minutes.
All right, well, I'll do it real fast then. Times of trouble, we decide what we need. What we take with us, what we leave. And how much of your answers can be believed. Nothing gonna save you if you're deceived. Can you live without water for 5 days? Can you live without shopping when you get paid? Can you live without having someone to blame? Can you live without the loser of your game? Can you live without this fine new car? Can you live without knowing exactly who you are? Did you ever doubt you'd have your house on the hill? Can you live without all the folks in their blue? Can you live without your dope, whatever it might be? Kind but wiser, looks the same for me. Can you live without never whispering your name? Can you live without in your fame? Can you live without her? Best make up your mind. Can you live without her? Boy, it's running out of time. Can you live without her? That's the way it's playing out. Can you live without her? Can you live without her?
Like 10 seconds to just hang out. So, Erica, don't panic. I did say we're live on Channel 16, but we're also multi-broadcasting, so we're a few places. And I'm going to start the show on Channel 16 Austin Music TV right now.
That's right.
We're going to do a John D. Graham song right now because we're no fools.
Realize I still have my hair and like my little olive oil bun from like working today.
I still have my mask on.
Oh, take it off. What do you look like? Listen, they can tell that we're doing something.
The cats
are begging to get in.
Cats are at the door. They know that we are live.
They want their audience.
We're coming to you live right now.
Yeah.
I'm just doing this.
Hey, how are you guys? God, that was a crazy week last week.
Yes. Congratulations to everybody who's still alive.
Mm-hmm.
Despite the best efforts of people who were looking to cash in on criminal negligence of avoiding spending money to protect our power grid and all the different things that entails, if you are still alive, congratulations. You are an evolutionary badass.
Yeah, not everyone was so lucky.
Good job.
We're really happy to be back. We're happy that the station's back up. Mm-hmm. They lost power last week, so we didn't have to do a show. It was like a odd vacation. But Sheila's manning everything today. She's just a busy chick. So thank you for picking it up like nothing happened. And we're happy to be here. And you're going to do a song, right?
I'm going to do a song.
Did you want to do it at the top?
I brought this guitar. I'm going to do a song. This is the song that was on my mind during the strange situations that we found ourselves in. And it wasn't like this was an unprecedented thing, because it was only 10 years ago where we had a multi-day hard freeze up in Dallas. So, and it was at exactly that time. Well, there was a government reaction, a study, and the people who are running the power grid were told they needed to winterize their equipment, which they did not do. So let's see some lawsuits, folks.
Hi, Sunday. Thank you, Jonathan. Hey, Lisa. Hey, Sue. Hey, Jim.
Nobody gonna bail me out. 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 Nobody gonna bail me out.
that a man. Nobody gonna bail me out. 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 Nobody gonna bail me out.
And I think to go along with the no bailing out, it's a perfect lineup for Jackie today. So here are some words of wisdom and some insight from Miss Jacquelyn Graham.
Get your spiritualism on.
Hello, everyone. Welcome back. I'm Jacquelyn Graham, and this is Uncomfortable Conversations. Last week, I talked about diet. I talked about physical diet as well as mental diet. We are all beings that are based on the input that we choose to put into our bodies and our minds. You know, our bodies are built from the building blocks that are created by the food that we ingest. Our mind is also trained and created by the input we put into our minds. There are a lot of people out there who are making their money from the fact that people will click on something that is meant to emotionally manipulate them. I call these people outrage junkies. So if you are constantly looking for things that are aimed at manipulating you emotionally and demonizing someone or something, then you're not giving yourself very good input. Anybody who is saying, "You can believe only me. Don't listen to anybody else. Don't pay any attention to any of that. They're all lying to you." How likely do you think that is? If you were looking for information that only feeds your outrage and your bias, and we all have bias, and I'm very serious when I'm saying whether you're on the left or whether you're on the right, you are doing a disservice to yourself, to your society, to the people who are around you when we don't want to deal with something else. But basically blindly following something, not believing information that goes against what you're being told by this particular source, it's not okay to play make-believe with somebody's life, with people's lives. You don't have the right to make decisions for other people. You don't have the right to force your beliefs on other people. A good portion of our laws here in the United States are based on that. And choosing good quality information, a wide variety of information, just like a wide variety of food, it's best for you. So open your mind. Take a look at the other team. You might understand a little bit more and recognize that when somebody has lost, they are in pain. Especially at a time like this, their reality has crumbled. So have a little compassion. Understand that, yes, they're going to be angry, they're going to be upset, and they're going to be very off balance because the reality they were basing their life on has been proven to be untrue. Try and put yourself in their shoes. Please feel free to contact me at any time, jacquelinegraham.voice@gmail.com, and I'm happy to talk to you. This has been Uncomfortable Conversations.
And we're back.
Thank you, Jacquelyn.
Yeah. Really nice.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, don't force people to believe any certain way.
Yeah, and we get addicted to righteousness. Mm-hmm. There's this an addiction to righteousness, you know, because righteousness is a emotion that clears away all conflict and all, and you know, all question. You know, it's like if you're righteous, you're all in. And that's something that we all would like to be able to do, but the world is a complicated place. We really have to pay attention.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, true. From all sorts of different sources.
What are we going to sing? You have a song?
I thought you had the one that you wanted
to do. I'm going to do the next one?
Well,
okay.
Or should I do one?
No, I can do it. What, I'm ready. Are we doing who?
Yes.
All right, I'm ready. Oh, gosh. Cat is crying to get in here.
Cat's in the basement.
Mm-hmm. Oh, Lisa Huffman says she loves Jacquelyn.
That's
we need
great.
To. It's nice to have that like soothing voice for just a few minutes.
Mm-hmm. Do you want to talk about this song?
I guess so. So this is the first co-write that we did.
Second co-write.
Oh yeah, because Daddy's mm-hmm. Listening was first.
Mm-hmm.
But this song we wrote started about 4 a.m. after gig. And Guy and I were sitting on the back patio kind of winding down, and he was crooning to me, singing some beautiful love songs. And then I was like, wait a second. Who did you write these songs for? And so then I got this kind of revenge.
Because it isn't about any one particular person. It's an amalgam of my experiences.
That's what he keeps saying. But
trying to create a situation that would be universally understood.
While you're chatting, I'll just throw our little,
Ooh, it's the PayPal and Venmo link!
She can't do a call to action.
Well, that's...
But
that is what that is.
We aren't doing a call to action.
I'm just saying what that is.
What?
This thing, what is it? What is it? You should do what you feel is right, of course. Because
you're good people, and we trust you.
Yeah. Gosh darn it, people like you.
Golly darn.
But like a clock, it goes around.
You co-wrote it with me.
I crush you with the song you've written.
I feel like I'm going to sneeze. This is the joy of live television. Oh.
So I'm going to play the song that I was playing when she came out, and we wrote that song.
The song that he wrote about no one.
So this is a very green song, because it's all repurposed chords. I fell in love with Hoagy Carmichael's song Georgia, and I would sit around and play it for hours and hours until I realized I was probably going to starve to death because the market for white boys singing Georgia is pretty limited.
And so I
decided, well, I had to do something, so... I took all the chords and I mixed them around and I put them in a hat, and this is the song that came out of it. Don't waste a moment on that one you left behind. Don't think for a second you just might change your mind. Things would be different if the whole wide world rewind. 'Cause you could say she's crazy now. It's not like you treat her any different than all the rest. Held for a moment and told you loved her best. Maybe she just felt it deeper inside the vest. You could say she's crazy now. She's crazy now. Used to spend every single sunrise. Sleep it off and get it on again.
She's crazy. inspiring me to write this song. Mm-hmm. I just want to do a little shout out to Jen White, who's watching from your mother's house, I believe.
She's in the house!
She's in the house! And I just wanted to do that shout out just because, you know, thank you.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm talking about. Thank you. And up next, we have Dan Johnson. And he's going to teach us some cool things about amps that maybe we didn't know.
Oh, this is very exciting.
Until today. Yeah, he thinks that maybe, I mean, you know, you could even learn something.
There's lots I could learn.
Hello, everybody, and welcome to another episode of Navigating the Musical Minefield with me, Dan Johnson. And today, if you can believe it, I am not going to be talking about guitars. I'm going to be talking about amplifiers. This is something we kind of need to discuss. I'm not Dr. Amplifier. I don't know everything there is to know. I know quite a bit. As far as effects and amplifiers and this and how you set them up, I know a little bit, but everybody's different. So I could sit here and tell you what works for me, and it might not work for you. I play pedal steel, Dobro, lap steel. Those things are very different than guitar and bass. But I'm going to kind of give you the basics of how to help you with your amplifier, all right? What I want to talk about is signal. Signal is this pathway, if you will. And every time you plug your guitar into the cable, into a pedal, into another pedal, into a wah-wah, into your amp, you're breaking your signal. And I'm going to use a sock today, Mr. Sock, to help you represent what you're doing to your signal, all right? So if we look at the sock unstretched, okay, that is going to be your true signal. It's beautiful. It's normal. The more you plug in things, this is what you're doing to your signal, okay? This is why when you go to a music store and you plug directly into the amp and there's no tuner or effects or anything, you're like, wow, this amp sounds great. You take it home, you plug in your pedal board, and it sounds like garbage. I'm going to help you with this, okay? Now, what I want to talk about to help you with your signal, a lot of amplifiers have a feature that you would be surprised how many professional musicians don't use this at all. They don't know what it does. They don't care. They don't want to hear it. I've tried to help them with it. So I'm going to help you with it, and maybe you'll understand, and maybe this will work for you. Now, first off, not all amplifiers are going to have this feature, but on a lot of amplifiers, you're going to have a preamp in or a pre-EQ patch, okay, with a send and a return. To put this in real simple terms, think of your amp as having its own brain, okay? And you're basically going to tell your amp, oh, not only do you have treble, mid, bass, reverb, you also have fuzz and reverb that's more expensive, or a delay that's super crazy. You're gonna kind of trick your amp, okay? Now these features come, some amps only have one set of them. Other amps will have two, okay? The one set sometimes will be before the actual brain of the amp, and some will come after, okay? So what that means is you could set up essentially two pedal boards. You can have an acoustic pedal board at the back and an electric pedal board at the front. So if you wanted to switch between your pedal boards, that's pretty complex sounding, but it really isn't. What this is going to do is it's not going to affect your signal. It's not going to affect your signal at all. It's going to leave you here in the normal wide open signal place that you want to be. And that's going to make the amp truly sound like itself. You're going to use these with your pedal board. And you're going to run your pedal. And I believe this is a tuner. And I have an EQ. And my EQ is my input. Okay? So my output will go to send. Like that. And my input will go to return. This will instantly solve a lot of your problems. Okay? You're going to love me. I don't use this in the studio. This is a live setting when I do this. And try it. Your amp might not have it. That's okay. Some don't. This is a PV amplifier. A lot of them do. Sometimes different amps have you know, all kinds of different features. This is going to be something that you can experiment at home. I'm not going to play it for you because I'm going to let you do the, you know, testing out yourself and decide if it's something that you want to use. It's going to clean up a lot of noisy pedals too. If you like pedals from the 80s or 1970 wah-wah pedals, whatever, crazy tuners, certain tuners will cause a really bad hiss, you know. This will clean a lot of that stuff up. So again, effects, send and return, okay? And they're named different things on different amps. You can figure it out. A lot of it deals with input and output. I hope that helps you. If you have any questions, you know how to reach me. Dan Johnson, Pedal Steel Guitar at yahoo.com. You can also reach me at Facebook, Danimal Johnson at Facebook. And remember, every Wednesday at 9, Channel 16, Awesome Music Television. This has been Dan Johnson helping you navigate the musical minefield. Have a good one.
Welcome back.
Welcome Austin, back.
And people who just wish they were in Austin, we're so glad to have you here. It's Wednesday, so we're doing the Wednesday show. I'm Guy Forsyth. This is Jeska Bailey. And Jess has a new song she wants to play.
I do. I'm getting the next segment queued up so that I'm ready when we're done with this. And I'll probably get really nervous and turn purple because it's a new song.
Okay, purple's a good color on you.
Okay, good. Oh, I thought I had a purple shirt on. But that was yesterday. So this is my newest song. And I'm sure that I will change. I will change. There's so many guitars in here. I was like, nope. I'll change it up as I go, but this is how it exists as of today. All right, this will be fun. I looked up saddest quotes.
Oh.
I didn't like use the whole quote, but I just used them to make my mood.
So you're saying it wasn't a personal experience, it was a gestalt experience built of different things to try to find comedy?
This is not a personal experience, this song has nothing to do with you. Now, let's go to our next segment. This is Patrick with Austin, Texas Musicians, who has been working his... Here, I'm going to say a bad word and you bleep it. Working his off all, like, since the whole thing defrosted here in Austin. And they're feeding everybody. They're feeding people. They're giving people shelter and water and doing amazing things. And, enjoy this. And if you're out there watching Pat, oh my gosh, we just sure love you. Thanks for being a part of this community. Patrick, again this week, Pat is a little exhausted because he's been so busy being a superhero with all the other superheroes in Austin, you should tell us about it.
You know, thank you, Jeska. It's good to see you again. Wow. I mean, what a crazy couple of weeks, right? You know, going from the frozen tundra to now needing to help our community. Mm-hmm. And I guess, you know, maybe the best place for me to start is to talk about how this all, you know, kind of started when things, you know, just barely started to thaw out last Thursday. And we realized maybe we could start to drive a little bit. I got together with Jeanette Greger from the Amplified Sound Coalition. And we talked about, well, what can we do here? You know, how do we mobilize some efforts to help the community? And then it was also that time that I linked in with Mayor Pro Tem, Natasha Harper Madison.
Hey y'all, Natasha Harper Madison here, right here in the heart of Central East Austin. Turnout was great today. We had a lot of people show up to get the things that they needed, and we had a lot of folks show up to drop stuff off. But if you keep an eye out on our page, all our District 1 social media, Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook, we'll be keeping you posted about opportunities to volunteer in the upcoming days. As it stands, we have some hot food that just arrived that was donated by Diplo. And then we have lots and lots of supplies. As you can see, we have water, we have pet food, we have people food, we have period products, and we have baby diapers and formula. I'd like very much to take the opportunity to recognize where a lot of these volunteers came from. So in addition to your local Buy Nothing groups, and next door, we also had most of our volunteers showed up by way of Austin, Texas Musicians, Texas Music Workforce Coalition, and the Amplify Sound Coalition. There are a lot of questions to answer. There are a lot of fingers to point. There's a lot of blame to be had, but not today. Today, we need to make sure our people are getting the things that they need, and that's what we're doing here out of the Millennium. That's what we're doing across town. And for more information about those specific opportunities, follow all our social media pages. Thank you, guys.
5 days later, everybody's exhausted. It's a well-oiled machine, but we probably cycled 600 or 700 unemployed musicians and venue workers through to volunteer and served, at this point, it's well over 1,000 families who needed food, water, everything. So, yeah, I'm tired. And it's still going on. This is Wednesday, and I guess we can, you know, look for the word on tomorrow, but there's still a lot of need out there. So it's water, food, diapers, formula, wipes, dog food, feminine products, PPE, masks, all that kind of stuff. Every day we run out, and every day our amazing community comes together to bring us more. It's been amazing to see all these hot meals come through via 313, Austin Food Company. Last night, restaurant donated 60 vegan meals to feed our volunteers. The artist Diplo somehow found out about us and donated 400 hot meals on Sunday. And so it's just been an amazing effort, you know, and we're seeing, you know, people these great, you know, wonderful faces in our community who, you know, we don't always see in the same place. So, you know, we see all these superstars rise to the occasion, and it's so inspiring to see.
Absolutely. Even in my little community out here, I live in Shadow Creek subdivision, mm-hmm. and everyone lost heat and water, and it's just been it's been terrible. I mean, let's not cover that, but it's also been beautiful watching everybody come together and help each other. One of my friends, Alexis, she's on day six of no water today, and she's got
Jesus, wow!
Like it's a real thing out here in Texas, y'all.
Yeah, definitely. Awesome. We're gonna make sure it gets where it needs to go, in every way possible. So. Yeah.
Well, I think that's all we're covering today. I think that's a big enough thing that we'll have plenty of pictures and stuff to show.
Yeah, we'll get back to our regularly scheduled programming soon.
But right now, you need to take a nap, Pat.
Man, I've been going on adrenaline and love, and you know, yesterday when you know all of us were completely exhausted, and the Isley Brothers came on, and I'm dancing with Mayor Pro Tem, Natasha Harper Madison, and all of our volunteers. And we're just, you know, at that point, you're just running on energy and love. And at this point now, I'm ready to go fall over on my side.
And you should. And
yeah, you should. I think I need
that. You have to get up and do it again, because that's what we do.
Yeah, that is it. We're here to serve. And, you know, and I just want to leave on this note. I mean, it's, we've seen all of our musicians, our venue workers, our industry workers, you know, we've all been out of work for a year. And yet when called upon, we mobilize the largest volunteer workforce imaginable. You know, we are FEMA for the city.
That's
pretty profound stuff. So
it's really cool. Well, thanks for giving back to the community. So you like are creating things out of thin air to give. And
you know,
cool.
That's how we do it. We just making it up as we go along. It's organized chaos, but we are here to serve, and I'm very humbled to be here with you.
Well, cool. This is Pat. He is with Austin, Texas Musicians, and they're just saving the world one bottle of water at a time. Thanks for being here.
Thanks, Jeska. We'll see you next week.
Welcome back.
Some beautiful stuff in the community.
Yeah, honestly, what's the great quote from Mr. Rogers? Every time you see a disaster or you know, some sort of horrible thing happening, look for all the people who are helping. And we definitely see that. So many people have stepped up, mm-hmm. and the communities are doing their best to try to take care of their own. Mm-hmm. And
especially the music community
That's very inspirational, yeah. But I'm constantly inspired by the musical community, because when there's a disaster, when there's a negative event, one of the first thing that happens is musicians or some of the poorest people are like, let's raise some money, you know?
Yeah, but we did get some good news from the mayor. Apparently, according to Patrick, all the volunteers that volunteered helping for the last few days, doing it completely for free, they found some money and they're going to pay them all.
Hey, that's great.
So all the unemployed musicians and all the people volunteering to help out, I mean, that's such a great feel-good thing.
Yeah, that will save some lives and some careers, definitely.
So what do you got for us now?
Well, this is a song that I wrote with my friend Jeff Plankenhorn.
Ooh, I know which one it is.
The greatest thing my mother ever taught me was to see the world through someone else's eyes. The salty and the sweet, the melody and the beat. Without the right wing and the left wing, that bird will never fly. So why don't you meet me in the middle, where we can agree, a good place to stand for you and me. Why don't you meet me in the middle, where we can get down. I see you, you see me on common ground. If you believe that freedom's for all men, all women too, justice for the least of us, bridling the beast in us, no matter who you are, I am with you. Why don't you meet me in the middle, where we can agree? If you believe that every child deserves shelter from the wild, understanding is a powerful word, and if you listen, you will be heard. Makes a way and gets us through our darkest day. We don't even have to fight. Sometime we can both be light. Just open up your heart, let it have its say. Don't you meet me in the middle where we can't agree? Good place to stand for you and me. Why don't you meet me in the middle? A song I wrote with Jeff Blankenhorn.
We got plenty of time to do more songs.
So I think that the Purgatory Players are going to do a benefit.
Yeah, this Sunday.
This Sunday, yeah. To help the Capital of Texas Food Bank. And so you can find them by doing a search for the Purgatory Players. And
also on Instagram. We on shared Instagram. It. So yes. It's already tagged on your Instagram and Facebook.
Great.
And all your social
well,
media.
Well, just go to my my Instagram page, yeah. Which is Guy Forsyth Band.
Linked up.
And you'll find that link right there, because there's some of Austin's best doing an excellent job of helping feed those in need, yeah. Right now.
Everyone's doing what they can. You're just moving forward.
Yeah.
Because that's the only way through.
Because it's the only option.
Yeah, that's all you can do. Or you can just cry a lot, and that's not fun. That's not fun! I want to say hi to Igor. You're watching from Brazil. That's really cool. And Jonathan is watching from Wilmington, North Carolina.
Oh, wow. That's great.
Yeah.
Thanks, everybody, for tuning in. Please tell your friends, because word of mouth is the gold standard when it comes to art. You know, everybody's going to tell you that it's the best, but if you really like this, please share it.
Yeah.
People are at their best when they're sharing the things that we love.
And now the link's like right here.
Ta-da!
Da-dee-da-doo-da! Mm-hmm. All right.
What's next?
I don't know. I did all my songs.
Oh, well, I guess I should play some more music.
Play another song!
All right.
And I'll think of another song, too.
Yeah.
One you got?
The last, not the last new one, the other new one, the mm-hmm. Wanna Break My Heart one. Mm-hmm. Let's try that. I don't know. Do you wanna?
Sure.
This song was written because I'm in a songwriting group, and this is the only song that I completed this whole semester. Okay, I hope I remember it. Are you ready?
Yep.
Here we go. Break my heart, wanna crush my soul, wanna watch me fall apart. Is this how I should go? Wanna fall in love.
How much time do we have left?
I don't know. We have like 6 or 7 minutes.
Well, I'm going to do another song.
Is it 58:30? I always get it wrong. And then Sheila always texts me like, this is the time. And I'm like, I know, I'm sorry. Thanks, Deb. Deb said beautiful. We also have David Beversdorf watching from Columbia, Missouri. Katrina Critchley. Watching from Augusta, Georgia. Nice.
Very cool.
And Dave says, missing you in Asylum, Guy.
I'm missing you in Asylum.
He's glad that you're staying busy, and he loves your dobro and harp.
Oh, thank you very much. Hopefully we'll see more from Christina Mars coming up soon.
Yeah. So. Oh, yeah, she's coming over to practice Friday.
Yeah, so hold tight. You know, good things are going to happen for you. Yeah, so I'd like to send this one out to everybody out there in the audience who is concealing a tattoo.
I only have this one.
Jack's out walking, you know he's tired of talking. He knows he's got to get out soon. He jumps a chain link fence and he dances in traffic to the shop where she bought her tattoo. Well, Rose cries on my shoulder, tell my shirt's cold in there. She says Jack is gonna take her apart. Never laid a hand on her, that's never been the case. But you know that is blood in her heart. We got dragons and daggers, taggers, roses and hearts. Long-legged ladies, ship skulls and sharks. A gilded scroll with anything you gotta say. And it will never go away. And it will never go away. She says, Guy, I just don't know what to do. Well, how can I love him this much and be sick of him too? Just to keep him right up there to change in her skin. She's got a twist of thorns and a single red rose cut with a stainless steel pin. We got dragons and daggers, tigers, roses and hearts. Long-legged ladies, ship scars and sharks. You know it's right below the belly so that no one else can see. So she'll be saving all the love for me. Saving our love for me. Flower on your back or your thigh. If they don't smell just as sweet as you hoped, you can hide them away from your eye. He says, Guy, I just don't know what to do. Well, how can I hate him this much and still love him too? I told her right to her face, what she wants to do. Dragons and daggers and that old harlot first. And if they ever ask you, well, damn right it hurts. But the sting is the thing. That's what they say. Sting. And it will never go away.
We'll be right back. We're just outroing on TV.
And it will never.
We're going to do a John D. Graham song right now. Called Needle Gun.
That's Needle Gun?
Yep.
That's the one Jonathan was asking about?
I think so. Cool. Unless it was the one that you just sang. What was that one called?
The last one I sang was Let's Fall in Love. But I bet he wasn't asking about the Taylor Swiftie sound.
Oh, yeah. We did the mashup of
that Christian
House of the Rising
song.
Yeah,
like that Christian.
Oh, that Christian song. That Christian song, yeah.
Hey, we're not on TV now, so we can definitely do calls to action.
Let's get naked. Come on.
No, that's what, no. I was going to say, look at you, made my ears turn purple immediately. If you have some money that you want to give to us, we'll take it.
Yeah, we are doing this in just blind hope.
Yeah, but also if you don't have money, it's cool. We don't either. So hang out with us and click the share button. Michael, I'm going to just totally ruin this last name. Michael Eovalasit. Thank you very much for your donation. And Hunter
Thank
Hicks.
You very much. Thank Thanks. You very much.
I've known Hunter forever. Remember Taylor, who I used to be best friends with?
Yeah.
Hunter is his cousin. So I've known Hunter since Hunter was like, most tall.
Excellent.
Thank you. And he makes really good, he's a really good cook. Anywho, what do we got now? Do you guys want us to play longer? Like, does anyone have a request?
Well, I have a request, and that's that you send us your feedback about the show. What's working for you? What's not working for you?
Yeah.
What can we do to better serve our musical community and also entertain you, the viewer? So.
Yeah. If you have a part of the show that you like a lot or dislike, or you just think all of it's so great, let us know what you're thinking so that we know what direction to go in.
And certainly our intention is in the future to have more acts on the show and perhaps to broadcast from different locations live and really showcase some of the fabulous live music that defines Austin, Texas.
True. And I'm also talking about putting together another TV show, which I would produce. That would be just an hour of Austin music news, which I think would be so great. We could have Pat and the Austin, Texas musicians, as well as Ham and Sims, and just, you know, local happenings, you know. I think it'd be really great. Mm-hmm. It'd be a lot of fun. We recently did a show with comedians interviewing?
comedians interviewing musicians,
and it was really great. We will be uploading the entire show to our Patreon, which is patreon.com/GuyForsyth. You can join that for as little as $5. So like, hey man, all of you that have donated tonight, donated at least enough to be a Patreon for at least 1 month, some of you for a few months. So we appreciate the donations, but we're in this for the long game. We want you to hang out with us and help us produce some albums.
Mm-hmm. So let's play another song. Want to play Snakes?
Yeah.
I really should write a verse about.
But I don't like the way that the
Texas trying to freeze you.
This one that much.
Want me to end that one?
Yeah. This one kind of has a high tinny sound, and it doesn't sound good on the E minor note that I. I keep thinking I'm messing it up, and maybe I'm messing it up. There's always the possibility that I've botched it. Oh, hey, Babbo, you're not too late.
We're going to play this song for you.
Oh, yeah, for you. Watching on YouTube.
1, 2, 3. There are snakes around my trailer. A scorpion in my bed. Snakes around my trailer. Found a scorpion in my bed. If Texas has its way, I could wake up dead. Black mold underneath the sheetrock. Paper wasps. Tried to keep up with the upkeeper. An honest man may be deceived. Oh, God help the child set upon my feet. It's a jacked up day where I wake up and I'm already late. Looking at the front door, I wonder what I run for to meet my fate. Gone without a trace, 100 right behind me to take my place. Hot sun working on the red clay, a it cracks just like a chain. Hell in August, Texas. Fools pray for rain. Oh, you dumb sons of bitches. Hurricane. You won't make it here. See that cowboy hat riding that Lexus. Venom in that wicked grin from ear to ear.
By the way, thank you to Patreon for that. And then the song's like, chop.
Well, I mean, that's, I don't know, that's more the radio edit, I would say.
Oh, I think it works really well. It's just, I just think it's fun when you start going to the studio and working with Matt, and then you come back, and it's like, I see things changing.
Yeah, definitely.
I'm not told, it's just like watching it, you know, it's kind of fun. we've got Hunter Hicks here who says he's a fan of some of the older stuff. Do you have something from Voices Inside or Adam's Rib?
Yeah, sure.
Yeah? Here. Take the princess again.
Got myself a story.
Ooh.
That I would like to tell. I was once just like you are now. Guess it's just as well. Got yourself a tan Texas woman. Beauty pageant crown. But that crown don't look so pretty now. She's out running around. Well, I've done my share of reading. I was a lonely boy. But you can't spread your life just sitting around waiting for all the food to bring you joy. My sermon continues. She was a restless woman with rambling on her mind. And I was a sweet, young, innocent thing just off the assembly line. She took me right out on the highway. The lady had a feeling for speed. When we hit 69 on those high bank curves, I thought, this is all that I'll ever need. Take it.
Yeah.
to think that people can change. She went out, found herself another cowboy, broke my little home on the range. Must have been some time while she was out bucking broncos. I kept the torch lit at home. Well, something snapped and the torch went. I came to this conclusion all of my own. Well, okay, so when I play this, usually I'm playing it in E flat, although right now my guitar is tuned down a whole step, so let's go through the different things here. I'm going to capo up to the fifth fret. If I was in standard tuning, I would be in, I would be here, but since I'm tuned down, I'm going to be here. But if you just want to know the basic positions that I'm playing, let me tune a little bit and I'll play the song for you. And then we can talk a little bit about the chords.
Learning songs with Guy Forsyth.
I should just write jingles. Maybe it's my calling.
Well, learning to tune.
It would probably pay.
Maybe. If they were good. I don't know if I'm going to write good jingles, let's be clear.
Nobody wants good jingles. They just want
our kids never words. Seem to like them.
There's a different time coming. A bad taste in the wind. The panhandle's burning and the winter's blowing in. Hard times for the stranger. Keeps them anymore. No one learns their lesson, they just bar the door. The trees on the green belt turn to Lipton brown. Justice just in letter, no salvation from the weather. I hope we are together when it all comes down. I hope I am with you when it all comes down. On the day the phones go dead, for the hungry come around. When the Greek boys lose their manners and the children torch the town. I hope I am with you when it all comes down. No one cares for the fallen. The clinic's doors are locked. No one here remembers Cassandra's cries are mocked. Beaten plows into pistols, planted brothers neath the ground. A hollow harvest rises, it all comes down. I hope I am with you when it all comes down. On the day the phones go dead, before the hungry come around. When the big boys lose their manners and the children torch the town. I hope I am with you when it all comes down. Tell John he was right. Carry what you can from the city's stock of stories, stacked till they can't stand. Ramona has a closet full of cans she keeps around. She said she's scared of starving when it all comes down. Goodbye, I'm with you. Phones go dead, for the hungry come around. When the big boys lose their manners and the children torch the town. Hope I am with you when it all comes down. Now I hope you understand why I'm choosing now to call. I know that we agreed to let that conversation fall. But there's different times coming, hard times to be alone. And I hope you can hear me. I hope you find this stone. There's just what you brought with you and can wrap your arms around. If the rapture doesn't take you, I will not forsake you. I am with you when it all comes down. I am with you when it all comes down. On the day the phones go dead, before the hungry come around, I'll leave nothing but a letter for those I would be found. That I've gone to be with you when it all comes down.
Bud Bluestein says, "Hey, Mr. Leonard." It's not actually a Leonard Cohen song, but Leonard Cohen is definitely an influence.
You wrote that one.
As a matter of fact, yes.
Yeah.
And so we're going to go over these chords. You can put the capo wherever you want. But basically...
Yeah, wait, make sure you have your pen and paper. Like,
yeah.
Get something to make notes with really quick. And if you join our Patreon, this is something that you could directly reach out to Guy... about any kind of song, because something you get with Patreon is direct interaction with the artist.
Yes. So, C. So, hope I am with you. F, E, A minor. Then back to C. Da, 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 da. D7. G7. Back to C. La, da, 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 da. F, E7, A minor. C, F, G, C. That's it. At the front end, I'm doing A minor to E7. That's an F7, E7, back to A minor. So if there's any other questions, let us know, and we'll do our best to help you out. And it's extremely flattering as a songwriter to have people being interested in your songs. So thank you very much.
Yeah. And if you play it you know, I'd love to hear the cover of it. That'd be fun to hear.
Oh, yeah, yeah, definitely. If, if you're covering one of our songs, let us know.
I'll totally repost it and tag you and everything.
Yeah, we'll put it up.
Can we do, I want to do the one that I took from you from Voices Inside.
Okay, sure.
I mean, I didn't take it. You gave it to me.
You stole my song!
It was his idea. How is everyone doing out there? I miss people so freaking much. You know, while you were doing that song, I had an epiphany.
Actually, let me use the Martin for this.
Sure. When It All Comes Down was the first song I ever sang in Austin. It was the first song I ever performed in Austin. And it was the first song I ever, like, had anything, like, affiliated with you. It was the first stage, you know? Mm-hmm. And it all did kind of come down. I didn't know that. I didn't know.
Mess around and find out.
Yeah. And I want to say, hey, Robert, thanks for watching the show. Robert says that the show sounds great.
Oh, great. That was our goal.
We took extra time and, like, did a super duper setup here. I can grab that camera and show them. I don't know if they care, but they're going to see it. After I shut my finger in that charger cord. So let me show you our setup here. Just black. It's just black. That's not what we were going for there.
We rented this coal mine cheap.
Oh, I had the wrong thing on. There, now it works. So here we go. Here's our setup. We got the mic, got lights all over. Running, this is where this camera was.
Running the mic through a Mix Pre 3. Yeah, the mic here is an ear trumpet Myrtle. Mm-hmm. A microphone that looks like a microphone.
And when you touch it, it makes noises. Ready? Boing,
boing. It has its own spring reverb built in.
We stream off of cell phones here. That is the Billy Cam. I'm holding the Brenda Cam. We name them after the people that have donated them to us.
Thank you, Brenda.
Yeah. So if you have an iPhone 6 or above that you'd like to donate, we'll take it.
Yeah, we really appreciate it.
Yeah. All right, are you ready?
Yes.
Look away. All my words can do is
haven't played long enough because our computer turned off. Let's check in. Was there a baby Yoda? Yeah, kind of. I put eyelashes on. But be careful because some of the eyelashes aren't honest. I didn't want to permanently put them on. I don't want to embarrass her by got to hold her up there. Or I guess you could do it to this one. Ready? Baby Gaga.
I'm Baby Gaga.
The show's really taking a turn here.
We'll probably be getting a letter from Lucasfilm lawyers.
Or maybe for Lady Gaga. It'd be really cool. Let's see if we can offend so they'll write us.
Desperate for communication.
Yeah.
Well, we want to thank everybody for tuning in.
Yeah, thanks for being here.
And helping us. Thanks everybody who's able to make a donation to help support us and the show. And if you don't have any money, that's just fine. You're our kind of people.
Yeah. Thanks for being here. We'll be here same time next week, same day. Mm-hmm. Wednesdays, we go live at 8:45.
If you have special requests for songs or any other special requests for pretty much anything, I mean, we'll try.
As we did today. Bye-bye. Thank you, everybody. I had closed the book because I got excited about Yoda. But thanks, everyone who donated. You know who you are. Maybe I'll write your name on the internet.